This video was inspired by the following Reddit post. The example shown here is an approximation of the model shown in the picture. I will be focusing on creating these slots. In creating these slots, I have set myself two main objectives. I should be able to easily change the extent of these slots without manually sketching each of them. I also want to automate the creation of these fillets. Whether I decrease or increase the number of slots, the fillets should be filled in automatically without error in the timeline. We are going to start with this simple shelled cylinder. This sketch here delineates the extent of the slots. I've left this underdefined so that we can adjust it later on the fly. With this sketch, we will be creating a surface body. I am planning to create a series of cuts which will terminate up against this surface body. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the sketch as the profile. Set direction to symmetric. Adjust the distance. I'm going to set this to an arbitrary distance, enough to extend well beyond the cylinder. I've created a sketch line on an offset plane from the top. This will represent the first cut. We need to make sure that this line does not exceed the extent of the surface body when looking from the top. This is to prevent any errors during the extrude process. Activate the Solid tab. Begin the Extrude command. Set Type to Thin Extrude. Select the sketch line. Set the wall thickness. Set wall location to center so that it thickens symmetrically. For extent type, set to two object. Instead of just selecting this face, we should go to the bodies folder and select the entire surface body. The importance of doing this will be apparent later when we perform the pattern. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. Set Object Type to Features. And select the extruded cut from the timeline. For axis, click on the select box and select the x-axis. Set distribution type to spacing. Adjust the quantity and spacing. Set the compute type to adjust, so that each individual cut will adjust up to the surface body accordingly. Bring back the sketch used to delineate the extent of the slots. Let's test how well the pattern reacts to a changing sketch. So why was it important to select the whole surface body during the extrude? Let's open up the extrude. Make the surface body visible. Remove the surface body as the object and select this face instead. Confirm the extrude. You can see that the slots just extrapolate out following the slope of this face. Even if you choose the adjacent faces option, it does not work. So it is important to select the full surface body. Next, we need to add in the fillets. It is obviously possible to add in these one by one. The problem with doing that comes when we need to change the number of slots. If we reduce the number of slots, we can expect errors in the timeline due to missing references. If we increase the number of slots, some slots will not be filleted. The use of rule fillets solves this problem. Instead of selecting edges, we will be selecting features. Begin the fillet command. For type, select rule fillet. For rule, select all edges. For features, go to the timeline and select the first slot, followed by the pattern. We need to round off internal corners, so for topology, select fillets only. Adjust the radius. Since we are selecting features to fillet instead of specific edges, we do not need to worry about changing the number of slots. Let's test this out by opening up the rectangular pattern. And increase the number of slots. You can also try decreasing them.